respected Sri Arun Kumar ji, the Secretary Mines, Sri S.K. Runta ji, His Excellency George, Mr. George, Director of Trade, Mr. Dilip Chinnar, Mr. Satish Rai, and all the delegates present here. Really, it is a great pleasure for me to be here and sharing with you our concern here. But at the same time, I would like to tell you, but every time I come to this building or interact with the people like you, I learn a lot. So I hope that by the today deliberation and whatever deliberation we done here, I will be really a united one. So in that context, I would like to say that the present, today's subject of the workshop is to explore the possibility of non-ferrous metals in coming 2013. And for that, the people are making some plans for that. And of course, this will require so many activities by you. But I must tell you that the forest and the environment and the mine, these are all required for the development of any country. So whatever we plan here, whatever the future plan we make, we must keep these things in mind, that a sustainable development and balance is maintained. And in the past also, as has been said, that the most of the minerals are situated in the forest area, and for which the clearances from the forest ministry is also required. And in the past years, we have simplified the procedure for granting forest clearances also. And still we are looking forward if further simplification of the process is done, then we will be happy to do that. But at the same time, we must like to caution all of you that the conservation of forest, environment and wildlife is not the only concern of the ministry and people working there. In fact, the economic activity which is going on, mining is one of them, maybe some other industry also, the people involved in these activities should also include these programs in their own initiatives, and we call them the mainstreaming of forestry in the mining sector. Why there should be a regulator like the Ministry of Environment to tell the people that you do this way or that way? I think it should come from within you also. If you don't follow, that's why we have certain rules and guidelines. So in that way, I will like that it is not only your concern, it is our concern and your concern both, that the environment and the forest and the other resources are preserved and it is used for the human kind for in a best sustainable manner. For that purpose, I would like to tell you that the forest and mining, in practically they are quitting each other for the land use. Either you have a forest and associated wildlife and other microorganisms and other things which we even don't explore even. In the forest, we don't know many things about the forest. The prospecting of the forest resource has also to be done. There may be certain plants or certain animals which we are not aware, which may be having a great future value for that, for the humankind and community as to come. So prospecting should also be done. So, but at the same time, the minerals which is lying below the forest land has to be extracted for the other part of the development in this country for the human being. Whatever mineral you extract is transformed into a useful commodity and is used by me only and everybody. So in that way, the one should keep the balance in this in our mind. And I am sure that everybody here is concerned and they are also taking care of this in their own programs. But we have certain regulations, you know, Forest Conservation Act was enacted in 1980 just to say that the forest should not be diverted on whims and fancy for that. So certain regulations, certain rules have been made for that. But one thing I must agree, and I think also agree, that the forest or non-forest area, the prospecting of minerals should be done. Minerals are resource. We must know where the resources are lying in the country. What is the value, what kind of thing. It is another matter whether we have to extract it or not. That is another thing, whether we will extract from forest or we will extract from outside. So prospecting is knowing your own wealth. You are knowing your wealth, where the things are lying. When you want to extract it, then you can always apply whether we should extract from the forest area or the non-forest area. If you want to extract from forest area, then what kind of mechanism should be there so that the minimum damage is done. So for the prospecting purposes, I don't think there should be any issue. But while extraction, you have to follow certain rules. So in the past, I think most of you may be aware that for the prospecting purposes, we have delegated certain powers to the state government, like up to any forest area having a forest density of say 10% and less. Up to that, the state government can allow the user agency for prospecting purposes. So for that, the ministry will not be approached for that. Even 10% to 40% crown density, like I mean, degraded forest area, if you want to be prospecting, you can always submit in a simple plain paper and give it to the regional office that is not crown. Of course, the dense area that we call after 40% more dense area, then you have to come as a prospecting processes. For that also, we would like to simplify if it is the need arises. So what I mean to say, the regulations formed by issued by the ministry, for whether it is for environment clearances or it is the forest clearances, I am sure that these are issued in consultation with all the stakeholders. You people are also associated with that, and so far so many regulations, so many relaxations has been given. With the objective that this should be increased pace, you can do that in the fastest way. But at the same time, we have not compromised the kind of thing we wanted to actually say. I mean to say, environment has to be protected, forest has to be protected, and if the alternate land use is to be done, then it should be very carefully it should be done, for which we have a cost-benefit analysis also. A mechanism we have already placed on the website also that you should also know it. Whenever any change in land use is proposed, whether you want to have a forest or you want to have a mine, so then you have to weigh the cost and benefit of both. If the benefit is more for the purpose of mining, then of course mining should be allowed. But if the cost, if the benefit is more in favor of the forest conservation, and then it should be not be open for mining. So this is the purpose of cost benefit analysis. So cost benefit analysis and other mechanisms developed should not be considered only as a piece of paper to be attached in the application form. The application of proper mine should be there so that it is actually serves the purpose for which it is there. When we consider in our meetings CV analysis hua hai, hani paper aa gaya. But I don't think that should be approached, it should be a part of the paper. Actually, you should also feel that we should really divert the forest land. I must assure you, whatever amount of compensatory afforestation, whatever NPV you are paying, that may be a monetary compensation, but it is not going to replace the thousand and thousand year old forest and the wildlife associated with it. You must appreciate that once a forest is open for mining or for whatever purpose, a loss of diversity is there and a loss of home to many wildlife who have no advocates to advocate. Only we people say on behalf of the animals, and we are only advocates here who talks. So we have to think on that line also. So in that way, I will like to sensitize you people that we are all here for the development. We are all here that mineral development should also take place. But at the same time, we also request all of you to kindly look the things from our angle also, so that you can also visualize the same thing which I am saying to you. So in that way, if you go in that way, I don't think there will be any issue from the Ministry of Environment and Forest. And we will be happy that you people are in a better shape and you are doing good in the business. Because ultimately, whatever you do, the benefits come to the greater society and the mankind. So in that way, I think the today's workshop will be much useful for all of you. And of course, the outcome will also be very much eye-opener to also. We will also take away from here the recommendation that you will be having. And we and I assure you that the Ministry of Environment and Forest will certainly not come in a way if your projects and proposals are appropriate for these issues, what I have said. And kindly mainstream forestry and wildlife and environment in road planning so that hum logon ka uske andar intervention kam ho. Why we should come and tell you do this on that end? You people are also of the same society from where we are. So in that way, we must look forward together so that this your job is there and your industry, mining industry, particularly non-ferrous, and you chop out a plan for 30 in that way. And my best wishes to all of you to be here. And really, it is a good thing for me that I am part of here, and I am certainly learning a lot of things. Thank you very much.